Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video we are going to discuss the Measure and Integration Theory. So firstly we'll discuss the Measure Theory, and in this Measure Theory, before going to that Measure, we should have an idea about the intervals. So we'll discuss the Lebesgue measure, and in this video we'll discuss the outer measure, inner measure and different types of measure and the properties of different types of measure. Before going to that, we should have an idea of the interval. So interval is nothing but an set which is an infinite set which contains the infinite element between two numbers, okay, not smaller than A and not bigger than or higher than B. So this is basically an interval. So interval is written in this way. I say it is an interval AB. Different types of interval here. So we'll discuss all the types of interval. The length of interval is defined as the difference of the endpoints. So basically the length of interval is defined in this way, that Li is nothing but B minus A. Obviously B is greater than, in this way B is greater than A always. So basically some important properties of the interval, if I will consider that if I is n, or say if I is interval, then there are different types of interval. That I closed, it means A and B belongs to I. If I is in this way, that close open, so it is basically A belongs to I but B does not belong to I. If I is in this way, that A, B closed, it means A does not belongs to I but B belongs to I. And I is equals to, in this way, that A comma B, it means A does not belongs to I and B also does not belongs to I. This is called closed interval, this is closed open, this is open closed, and this is open interval. So there are different types of interval in which the length of this interval is nothing but L of I. In the all the cases, L of I is B minus A. Okay, so this is the first point. Second point is basically, if I is equals to phi, the empty interval, then the length of this interval is zero, obviously. Then third point is basically, if I1 is subset of I2, I have this 5, 7, then obviously 5, 6 will be the subset of this. So basically it is I1 and it is I2. Okay, so I have these two interval. So in this case, the length of I1 is less than equal to the length of I2, because set itself is a subset. So you can see the length of this I1 is nothing but 7 minus 5 is 2, and length of I2 is 1. So basically 6 minus 5 is equals to 1. So it means, you know that I2 is subset of I1, so the length of I2 is less than length of I1. Okay, that is 2 and 1. The fourth property is basically, for the interval, the fourth property is said that if you have I1 and I2 are two interval, then are two interval, then I1 union I2 is also an interval. I1 union I2 is also an interval, and the length of I1 union I2 is less than equals to length of I1 plus length of I2. So this is the result. Then the fifth point is, length of I1 intersection I2 is phi. Okay, I1 intersection I2 is phi. Then if the length of I1 intersection I2 is phi, or basically wait, not the length only, if I1 and I2 intersection is phi, then the length of I1 union I2 is equals to I1 plus I, the length of I2. It means it says that if two intervals are disjoint, if two intervals are disjoint, like in this way, I say I1 is equals to 5 to 7 and I2 is equals to 8 to 9. So it means it is 5 minus this and basically wait 7. And this is basically 8 to 9, yeah. Yeah, it is 8 to 9, okay, you can write. So the length of I1 is nothing but 2 and the length of I2 is 1. If you are going to calculate the I1 union I2, so what is the I1 union I2? It is basically 5 to 7 union 8 to 9, the close interval. So the length for this is basically length of I1 union I2 is nothing but 2 plus 1 is equals to 3. In this way that we can write. Okay, you can't write 5 to 6 because this is not disjoint. But if it is in this way that 5 to 7 and 7 to 9, then the union you can write that 5 to 9, but this is not disjoint because there is a 7 which is in a common. Okay, so these are the some properties of the interval. Now come to the measure or outer measure. So what is the outer measure? Outer measure says that let A is a subset of interval AB. Be any bounded subset. A is basically the bounded subset of interval AB of a real number. Then outer measure of A is denoted and defined as M star. It is denoted like in this way, M superscript. In the superscript there is a star and A. It is basically infimum of length of F. Then what is F? F is where infimum is taken over the length of all open sets. F is the all open set. S is the all open set which containing A. Which containing A. It means A is contained in A. So this is the basically the definition of the outer measure. Then F is F be an open set and can be expressed such that union of open intervals. So because A contained in F, then that is basically union 1 to infinite all the interval. Obviously we have defined this is nothing but I. We have defined that A contained in interval I and A contained in F. Then this there is a relation that A contained in F and F contained by the union of F contained by the union of all the I. This is the relation between the all sets. Hence, in terms of interval, the outer measure of A is defined as, in terms of interval, the outer measure is defined as M star A is equals to infimum, that summation L I N, that the summation length. Basically, the union will convert. Whenever you are going to find the length and the you will take an infimum over the length. So, you have to add all these length. Okay. In this case, in the interval, there is a union. Because of that, you will take all the elements. Now you are going to take the length. Length is a number that you have to add. You have to sum all the lengths. That M star A is equals to infimum of N is equals to 1 to infinite and L I N. Okay. Now, for an empty set, outer measure is 0. If you have I is equals to phi, then the outer measure A is equals to the infimum of summation of length. The summation of Li, and we know that this the length for this is equals to 0, so M star A is equals to the infimum of 0, it is nothing but 0. So the outer measure for this is equals to 0. So outer measure is nothing but the length of this outer measure is the summation of outer measure is the infimum of, you can see infimum of sum of all the length of interval, or you can say the infimum of length of the F. F is nothing but F which contained A. It means that A is containing within the F. Okay, and F is the set of all the open, like F is the all the open set. Now, what is the inner major? It is just opposite. You will write, you will denote in this way, then the super, in the subscript, you will write the star A. It is nothing but the supremum of the length of all B. Where B is, supremum is taken over the length of all closed set B, which contained the outer major is computed by an open set F, which is contained in A. It means that now this is the very interesting, and there is a point that is you should know about this, that the relation between the outer measure and inner measure, it will show in this point, but in this particular point. Now the inner measure, you will see the inner, in this inner measure, M star, basically what is the outer measure, this M star A is less than, obviously it is less than or the length of F. Infimum, we will take the infimum. In this case, A contained in F. Now, A contained B. It means B containing in A. Okay, B containing in A or B containing in A. It means that B is all bounded set. All bounded set. Here F is all open set. Okay, this is the case. Where the inner measure is computed by the closed B which are contained in A. All the closed B are contained in A. In general, both outer measure. In this case, both outer measure and inner measure are not equal to each other. This is in general. We'll say that in general, that outer measure of A is not equals to inner measure of A in general, but there is some particular case when these both will equal. Now, what is the definition of miserable set? So, what is the miserable set? A set is said to be miserable set if outer measure of A is equals to the inner measure. This is simple. If the set is called the miserable set, it means that the outer measure of A is equals to the inner measure of A. This is the miserable set, that is MA. It means that we can define, so it will equal. So we can define in this way that outer measure of A is equals to inner measure of A is equals to some MA. So, we'll denote this miserable set by this MA. Now, theorem. There is a theorem that prove that a set A be a set, then prove that outer measure is always greater than inner measure. This is the very simple case, and we can define, obviously, that we are using the definition. So, the proof for this theorem. So, first of all, let us consider the inner measure. The inner measure of set A is bounded. Okay, the inner measure of set is bounded, and FB all open set. So we know that B contained in A, bounded set B, and F are the all contained. In the, like by the definition of supremum, by the definition of inner measure, that B contained in A, B is nothing but bounded set. This is basically bounded set. A is a simple set. A contained in F, which is all open set. Now, taking supremum over all closed and bounded subset of A. What are the bounded subset of A? That is B. So, we will put the supremum on the A. Supremum on the subset of the A, which is B. It means if I will take the supremum in this way, okay, yeah, if B contained in A, then obviously the length of B is less than the length of f, because these two are the interval or sets in the way of in this way of the intervals. So we will take the supremum. So how can we take the supremum? So basically in this way that we will take the supremum of length of b, which is less than the length of f, which is less than the length of f, and this will contain in f. So now we will take infimum over the all open set which contained A. You can write in this way, which containing set A. So the supremum of LB is less than, we'll write this is the set. Okay, it means you will take the infimum, the right side. So these two are nothing but this is inner measure of A less than equal to the outer measure of A. So basically this is the relation that we can find the we can prove this theorem that outer measure is always greater than inner measure. So this is the concept of the measure, and there are so many theorems in this, so we'll do within our upcoming lecture. So this is just an introductory video that we have discussed that all the types of different types of interval, the length of interval, and we have already also get an idea about the outer measure and inner measure. So I hope you got the concept of the concept and definition of the measures, and we'll discuss further this topic in our upcoming videos. So please like the video, share the video, and subscribe the channel. So, thank you. Bye bye.